everybody. My name is Heather, and I'm coming to you live for my Pilates and yoga class this afternoon. So I'm so glad that you decided to show up. I'm going to give you a minute to find yourself a nice good space in your home or on your mat, to turn on your favorite music, and we will get started. So let's start in child's pose to give everybody a second to gather themselves, and then we'll get right to it. So just find yourself on your mat or on your floor, find yourself a nice comfortable child's pose, just take a moment for yourself and we'll get started. All right, so let's find ourselves in the middle of our mat. We'll come to our traditional tabletop position. So just starting here, we're just going to start to really press away the floor. I want you to engage that core, so pull that belly in. We're going to start to build some heat there in a second. So pulling the shoulders down, pull the elbows in, just nice and strong here. And now let's dig those toes in, let's fire up that belly. So let's lift up those knees, just an inch or two. Pull that belly in tight. Look down at the mat between those two thumbs. Keep pushing away the floor. Keep pulling those shoulders down, so a lot of arm strength here, keeping those knees directly underneath your hips, keeping the breath nice and steady. Good. Now let's just tap those knees down and lift for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Hold for 10. Position, keeping those hands underneath those shoulders. Again, you're going to keep pulling and pushing away that floor, so really actively pull those shoulders down. You're not just hanging out here. I want it to be a nice active hold. So keep those feet together, push those heels back. Keep the belly in, pull those shoulders down, breathe. Good, and let's just continue to warm up here. So we're going to move from plank to downward dog and then back to plank. So let's do 10 sets of that. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold your plank position and drive that right knee right to heart center. Point the toe. Let's start with a hold. Bring it back to parallel. So it's like you're rounding into yourself and then bring it back down. For 10, 9, keep the core tight the whole time. Keep that left leg straight. Try to connect that knee with that chin. 5 more. 3, 2, last one. Good. Now pull it back up and hold for 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now shoot that right hand to the outside of those hands, and let's just twist it up. So extend that right arm tall, just a little nice stretchy stretch. And then bring that right hand back down, right foot meets the left, hold your plank, breathe. Get those hands underneath those shoulders again. Flex those feet, push those heels back. Those downward dog wings again for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, hold. Now pull that left knee in, point the toe, same thing on this side. So start with a hold for 10. 9, yourself up here. Pull in that belly. Breathe for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now open up those hands and let's do 10 push-ups for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Now walk those hands back to your feet. Feet are flat together. Slowly rise. Good. So here we are at the end of our mat. I want you to pull that belly in. Bring your chin to your chest. Slowly round all the way down. Fingertips to the mat. Walk it out to your plank position. Good. Now bring your right knee to right elbow. Left knee to left elbow for 10. 9. 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Keep the feet together. Walk those hands back. Pull that belly in. Slowly round up. One vertebra at a time. Good. Again, roll down. Walk it out. So you're in a nice strong plank. Now we're just going to bring those knees down center. Like mountain climbers, nice and steady for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Feet together, walk those hands back. Pull the belly in, slowly rise. Good, now scoop the belly back in, bring it back down. Tricep push-ups for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Walk it back. Slowly rise. Good. One more time. Bring it down. Hold it on one side. Keep that other leg extended. Just shift your eye gaze down at the edge of your mat for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Other side for 10. Side, come on, for 10, 9, 8, 7, for series. So bring those palms flat underneath those hips. Extend those legs long. Pull those shoulders down. Anchor them to the floor. Keep those legs together. Inhale over. Open and exhale down. So feet are mat width apart. And close. Inhale. Open. Exhale. Palms stay flat. Take your time. Close. Inhale. Open. Exhale. Close. Inhale. Open. Exhale. Press that lower back into the floor. Close. Inhale. Open. Exhale. Keep your head flat. Close. Inhale. Open. Exhale. Close. Inhale. Open. Exhale. Close. Inhale. Open. Exhale. Close. Inhale. Open. Exhale. Now keep those legs open. Same thing. Inhale over. Close and exhale. Again. Open. Inhale. Close. Exhale. Keep those shoulders down. Open. Inhale. Close. Exhale. Open. Inhale. Close. Exhale. Open. Inhale. Close. Exhale. A few more. Open. Inhale. Close. Exhale. Open. Inhale. Close. Exhale. Last one. Open. Inhale. Close and exhale, right into the jackknife. So similar move, inhale over, lift those legs high. Now drop those hips, press that lower back, pull the shoulders down, and draw those legs nice and slow all the way down to parallel. Let's do that again. Inhale over, lift, exhale, release, legs come down. Inhale over, lift, exhale, release. Legs come down. Inhale over. Lift. Exhale, release. Legs follow. Two more. Inhale over. Lift. Exhale, release. Legs follow. Last one. Inhale over. Lift. Exhale, release. And legs come down. So your legs are parallel. Let's keep them parallel. Keep that head on the floor. And just hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now bring them up halfway and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now lift the head and shoulders. Look at those legs and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring them down to parallel and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly lift them all the way up. Release those hands. Bring them by your side. Start pumping those arms, rubbing into the 100. So lift the chest a little bit more while pulling the shoulders down. Arms are nice and engaged, so that means your triceps are nice and tight. Fingertips are together, one solid arm. Keep that pumping nice and steady. Keep that eye gaze right down center. So look toward your belly button, pressing that lower back into the floor, keeping those legs glued together as straight as you can comfortably. Pull those shoulders down away from the ears, keeping them off the mat. Good, nice slow inhales through your nose, nice slow exhales through your mouth. Good. Keep going. So guys, when I talk about your breath with certain moves, like there's a purpose behind that. Like Pilates is all about the breath connecting with the movement. So it's because your transverse abdominis, that's your abdominal wall, like it's connected to that breathing. So when we inhale, when we contract, exhale, it's all connected. So there's a purpose sometimes when I tell you to inhale at a certain point or exhale at a certain point when we're in a certain position. Let's continue here for 10, 9, pop it out for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now grab a hold of that right knee, pull it in, and then swap it out. So we're moving into the single leg stretch now. So you're keeping that lower back flat, keeping that chest lifted, shoulders pulled down away from the ears, eye gaze right down center. Keep those toes pointed. Keep those elbows in close. Give that knee a little hug as you extend that other leg nice and long. Find that hold. You're not going fast here. You want to keep that core contracted for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, bring it back center. We're going to bring those legs to tabletop. We're going to lift the head and shoulders again off the floor, bringing those hands to the outside of those knees. We're going to extend everything nice and long, try and get as close to parallel as we can comfortably without compromising our lower back. And then we circle those arms back around to the outside of those knees. So extend out and bring it in. It's an inhale out, exhale in. So get moving. Try to keep those feet and knees together. Like I said, you want to try to bring those legs them back, pulling those shoulders down away from the ears, but keep those shoulders off the floor. Keep the eye gaze down center. Bring your chin closer to your chest for me. Reach long, bring it in. Inhale out, exhale in. Take your time. We're here for 10 more. Breathe through each one. More. And then we're going to move into the bicycle. Four, three, two, and one. Good. So just stack those hands behind your head and with your elbows nice and wide. Good. You just like the single leg stretch, pull one knee and extend the other leg. Bring the elbow to the outside of the knee and swap it out. So we're just adding in that twist. We're still extending that leg nice and long, keeping that belly in, the edge of your mat. As you twist, lift that shoulder nice and high, really reach, twist it out. For 10, 9, we'll do some holds at the end and then we're going to repeat. Pick a side and hold. Look at the edge of your mat. Get the elbow glued to the outside for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Other side and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to crisscrossing it out for 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Last one. Let's hold again. Come on, for 10. 10, one. Legs are up. Now just lower those legs to parallel and lift. So bring it down. Nice steady pace, not too fast. Enough to keep that core tight the whole time so you can feel it. Keep those shoulders pulled down. Keep that eye gaze right above you. Keeping those hands underneath those hips for stability. The lower you come to parallel, you should feel it tighten up in that lower belly, yeah? When you bring those feet up, you're not shooting them up overhead, right? You're just coming right up to, right over your hips so you can keep that lower back flat. You're not lifting that tailbone. Do 10 more, because these are so good. And then we'll probably hold down there. Do some work. 5 more. Pushing away the floor with that top foot. Keep pushing away with that bottom hand. Hold nice and strong here. Just use your breath for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, shoulder. Really reach it through, like someone has those fingertips and is just pulling at your arm. So keep that core in tight. Hold it here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. That arm extends tall, and then that hand comes down to the mat, and you return to your plank position. So set it up. We're going to breathe right here. 10 solid inhales and exhales. So we're here for about 30 seconds. Holding nice and strong. Keep the belly in. Keep those heels pushed back. Keep those shoulders pulled down. Halfway there. Focus on that breath. You're going to be able to hold yourself up. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now let's center the other hand. Good. And we'll turn into our side plank on this side. So same thing. Let's set it up. Those arms are in a nice straight line. You're pressing away the floor, that bottom arm. Top arm reaches tall. Keep those hips stacked, one over the other, belly in tight. And shift that leg up and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Reach that arm overhead, lifting that hip high, belly in, hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Drive that arm underneath the shoulder, twist right into it, pull that belly in and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Reach that arm tall and bring that hand down. Return to your plank position. Focus on your breath again. Slow the inhales and exhales down. Shift that eye gaze between your two thumbs. Good. Pull those shoulders down. Pull that belly in. And let's bring it down to the elbow plank. So, keep everything nice and solid here. Pull those shoulders down. Back is flat, belly in. Push that energy back through those heels. Breathe. Good. We're going to hold here for 1 minute. So starting now, we're just going to focus on our breath. So inhale. Downward dog. We are in elbow plank. We're moving back so our forehead comes down to the floor. Pulling those shoulders down. Drive those heels toward the floor. Maybe you can bring your nose to the mat as well. Just hold here. Press that chest forward. Keep that belly in tight. Hold here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Return to elbow plank, and let's move into side plank. So I want you to center one elbow and come onto your side, stacking those feet. Lift that arm up nice and tall. Good. You want your elbow right underneath that shoulder. Again, keeping the hips stacked, belly in, nice and strong here. We're just going to dip that hip and lift for 10, 9, 8, slides to the top corner of your mat. Hips are still stacked. We're going to drive that top arm overhead. Keep the belly in tight. Use that bottom arm as your anchor arm. You're going to push into that hand. Drive the legs up to meet the arm and drop it back down for 10. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Now bring it all up and hold for 10. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. Now stay here. Just drop that bottom leg and lift for 10. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Good. Bring it all down. And bring it up. Let's bring it to the other side. So we'll start with that side elbow plank. So, coming up, elbow under the shoulder, stack those feet, make sure you're in a nice straight line. Take a moment, extend that arm tall. Good, now we're gonna dip and lift for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Gently bring it down. Extend that bottom arm on this side. Bring those legs to the top corner of your mat. Bring that top arm over. Good. Pull the belly in. Let's bring those legs to meet the arm. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now pull it up and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower that bottom leg for 10 and lift, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, elbows. Good. Extend those legs out. And what we're going to do is we're going to pull those knees in to tap those forearms and extend it out. So get moving. Let's keep those elbows over the shoulders. Keep your head flat. Keep your belly in. Really reach those legs long. Good. You got to lift that tailbone to get those knees to tap those forearms. You can drop those legs for a moment. Let's reach those arms back and then bring everything to meet in the middle. Good. Now lift your head and shoulders and let's just reach for that opposite foot. So just twist it out, pressing that lower back down, keeping those shoulders off the floor, belly in tight, eye gaze up at those toes for 10. Let's bring those arms up to meet those legs. We're going to drop everything down to parallel and bring it back to meet in the middle for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, two. And last one. Good. Drop that head. Good. Drop the feet. You can give those knees a little hug. And then come up. I want you to come up to those forearms for me. So on your forearms, let's start by tucking those hands a little bit underneath those hips. It's just going to help anchor you a little bit more, I find. Extend those legs long. We're going to scoop those feet in. Lift and then flex those feet as you bring them down to parallel. So you can start. You're keeping that chest lifted, shoulders pulled down. Take your time. Nice and slow, drawing those legs down to keep that core nice and tight. Five more and we'll reverse. Both legs for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do the left side. Nice and strong. Here we are in tabletop position. I want you to extend the left leg and extend the right arm. So here we are in bird dog. Shift the eye gaze down. Press the weight out forward with your left foot. toward center and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Extend and return to your tabletop position. Let's do the other side. So extend the right leg and the left arm. Begin by lifting the right leg, pressing away the floor, and then reaching the arm and leg. Good. Pull the belly in, keep the eye gaze down, let's meet everything at heart center, and extend for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Pull it back together and hold for 10. Drop those heels, wide downward dog, hold. Stretch out those hamstrings, push that chest forward. Palms flat, fingertips nice and wide like starfish, right? Hold here for a couple breaths. And then we'll do that other side. Good, so drop both knees to the floor. Top of your right foot is flat. Extend the left leg, pull it into the knee, and extend for 10. So here we are in a nice strong plank, right? Hold here. Keep the belly in. Just breathe. A couple breaths, and then we're going to bring it down and hover. So breathe. Nice deep inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Next inhale. Exhale, bring it down for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Push it up, release the right foot, push it back, downward dog. Hold, drop those heels, let it go, push it all away. Good, now keep the right heel down, extend the left leg up. Both legs are straight, let's tap those heels and lift. For 10, keep the core tight. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Pulse it out for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Place that left heel on top of your right heel. Hold it nice and strong. Let's have a couple breaths here. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Next inhale. Exhale down and hover for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Push it up. Release the left foot. Push it back. Good. Now lift that right leg up. Hold it right here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it halfway and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Both legs parallel for 10. Bring it down onto your back. Good. So we've got just a couple minutes. So we're going to do a bicycle burnout. All right. So stack those hands behind your head. Lift it up. And let's just twist it out. Come on. We're just going to keep moving here for these last 2 minutes. So I want you to dig deep. I want you to grab on to whatever it is that's going to keep you moving for these 2 minutes. Because you can do this for 2 minutes. modify if you need to. But you know, I don't like that word modify. It just means you just do you. So whatever that looks like, this is how it looks like for me. It might look different from what you're doing, but you're moving and I'm moving, and that's the goal. So if you're in it, you're not sitting here watching these last 2 minutes. You came this far, so let's keep moving. Pull that knee in tight. Extend that leg long. Tap those feet if you need to. Keep those hands behind your head. Keep looking at the edge of your mat. Keep that belly in. Keep the breath steady. Come on. More than halfway there. You've got it. We're going to keep moving right to the last second. And then we'll move right into yoga. So come on. It's you and me. We're going to keep moving together right to the end. Got your back. Come on, come on. We came here to work, but you know what? We came here to build a stronger mindset today, didn't we? And that's going to be the success from this hour. If you have a stronger mindset, if you have a more positive outlook when you're done with this hour to carry you forward into your evening, then that is success. So, come on, keep going. We've got 30 seconds to go. Come on. Here we go. Keep twisting. Keep breathing. Keep moving. One breath at a time. One twist at a time. You've got it. Find your strong. Last 15 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo-hoo. How was that for a little bonus? Physical burnout. It's my new thing. All right. Let's start in Happy Baby. I just think that would be a really nice transition into yoga. So let's bring those feet up. Grab onto the outside of those feet and just rock it out. That should just feel really good. And feeling good, that's the whole purpose that's the whole purpose in exercise, isn't it? Like, isn't that the purpose of exercise? It's to get those natural endorphins, right?
Shoulders down. Press your forehead and nose into the floor. Push that chest forward. Pull those shoulders down. Sit back on those heels. Give me a couple nice inhales and exhales. Good. And then let's push ourselves up and we'll start in downward dog. So set yourself up for that. Get yourself into downward dog.
Pressing away that floor, keeping those shoulders pulled down and back. Take it here for one breath. And then move through plank right to your downward dog. Good. Walk those feet forward, hands to your hips, and slowly rise. Good, so we're gonna come into a variation of half moon. Let's bring those feet together. I want you to bring those arms up overhead and grab onto opposite elbows. Okay, so we're not extending those arms fully, but I want your hands gripping those elbows. So it's like you've got a little frame around your head. Pull the belly in, good, lift the chest, pull the shoulders back a little bit, and now just slowly begin to bring those elbows to your right. So just like half moon, when our arms are fully extended, we're still using that arm strength to reach and pull that left arm over. So this time, you're using that right hand to kind of pull that left elbow down. Just a nice, gentle pull. But you're still creating that same curve, still a nice stretch on your left side. Pull the belly in, bring that right shoulder forward a little bit, and lift that chin. Good, nice solid weight in those heels. Legs are straight. With every breath, you're coming a little bit deeper. Good, and then let's slowly return to center. Good, let's push away the earth, lift that chest again. Take a nice deep inhale, and let's drop it to our legs. So keep that belly engaged, nice and tight. And you're just dropping that left elbow down now. Good, and you are keeping the grip with that right, or that left hand on your right elbow, and giving it a gentle pull. Shoulders down and back. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Nice arch in your back. And then move for plank, downward dog. Right heel down, left leg extends. Bring that left foot through, preparing for crescent on this side. So sit down low, weight in your left foot, lifting those arms. Hand comes down to the outside of that foot, step it back, set it up in plank, and go through your vinyasa. Upward dog, hold here for a breath. Nice, strong inhale up. Exhale, bring that right arm under the left. Twisting those hands like ropes. Good. I want you to lift those arms nice and tall. Good. So they're right in front of your face. Lift, lift, lift. Elbows in line with those shoulders. Come down nice and low. Lift that right leg over your left. Tucking that foot behind. Sit down nice and low. And then hinge forward. So holding this humble eagle. Arms tall again, and then releasing that foot, releasing those arms up overhead, and now bring that left arm underneath, twist those arms like ropes, stand tall for me, and then lift those twisted arms up, sit down nice and low, lift the left leg over the right, tuck that left foot, sit down a little lower, drop those arms in front, bring them down to parallel. Turn to the top of your mat. Let's flow again. So feet together, hands in prayer. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, release. Step those feet back to your plank position for one breath. Bring it down for your vinyasa. Hold. Move through plank, downward dog. Left heel stays down, right leg extends. Bring that right foot up and through, square off the back foot, preparing now for warrior one. So stay down nice and low in the lunge, lift those arms up again, bring that left hip forward. Good. Keep those arms tall for one breath, and then open up those arms, warrior two. Good. Bring that left hip forward, keep those arms reaching, pull the shoulders down, look over those right fingertips. Now reach that right arm forward, and drop that hand to the inside of your right foot, extending your left arm tall, holding this nice side angle. Keep the left leg straight. If you want to add the bind, bring your left hand to your lower back. Bring that right arm through. Grab onto those fingertips. Hold. Reach that left arm tall. Good. Left hand comes back to the floor. Square off the back foot. Step the right foot back. Move through your vinyasa. Upward dog. Move through plank. Downward dog. Good. Let's do the other side. So extend the left leg. Bring that left foot through. Square off the back foot. Slowly rise when you're ready into warrior one. Bring the right hip forward. Good. Now open up those arms, warrior two. Bring the right hip forward again. Pull the shoulders down. Keep reaching those arms. Look over those left fingertips. Sit down a little bit lower. And then reach that left arm forward. Drop the left hand to the inside of the foot. Reaching the right arm tall. Hold. Drop that right hand to your lower back. Bring that left arm under. Grab onto those fingertips if you can and hold. Good. Release that left hand. Reach that right arm tall. And then bring that right hand to the floor. Good. Bring that left foot back to meet the right. Hold your plank. Set it up. And move your vinyasa. Bring it down. Upward dog. Move through plank. Downward dog. Good. Walk those feet forward to those hands. Slowly rise. Good. And let's work now.
place those fingers underneath the right knee. Begin to stand nice and tall. Find that nice, strong left leg. Pull those shoulders down and back, lifting that chest. Use that bicep strength to pull that knee in. Belly in tight, eye gaze in one spot. Stand tall. Good. From here, let's move into standing pigeon. So left hand grabs the right heel. Right hand underneath that shin. Try to get that shin parallel. Pull the shoulders down and back. Stand tall. Hold here. Moving into seated figure four. Place that heel above the left knee. Hands to prayer. Slowly sit down. Extend those arms up. You can open those branches. You can bring those hands together, releasing those index fingers. Good. And then bring those hands back to prayer. Now take that left arm. Bring it out by your side, palm faces forward. Take your index finger and middle finger and grab onto your big toe. Get a nice tight grip. You might just want to stay here, or you can begin to extend that leg out by your side. Hold here for a couple breaths. And then draw that foot in. Release that right foot. Draw both arms now by your side, mountain pose. Let's take a nice deep inhale. And exhale it all out. Good, so let's do the other side. So right leg is straight. We're going to lift that left knee, prepared for standing wind removing pose. So interlace those hands, get a nice grip, and then begin to stand tall as you draw that knee toward your shoulder, pulling both shoulders down and back. Keeping those elbows in. Relax that left foot. It should hang heavy. Good. Stand nice and tall. Pull that belly in a little bit. From here, moving on to standing pigeon. So, opening up that knee, bringing your left hand underneath the shin. Right hand grabs that heel. Try to get that shin parallel, stand nice and tall, pull those shoulders down and back again. And then place that heel above your right knee. Bring those hands to prayer. Pull the belly in and begin to sit down a little bit lower. Come into right to your edge. So keeping the chest lifted. Keep those shoulders pulled down and back. here in the middle of your mat. You're just going to turn so that we can open up those legs nice and wide. So go ahead and open up those legs. We're going to keep both hands on the mat for right now. So just press away that floor, keeping those legs straight. We're just setting this up. So nice flat back while you're right here. Let's open up those hands a little bit so your hands are underneath those shoulders. Good. Keep those hips square. Keep that belly in. Now turn those left fingertips to the right and just extend that right arm tall. Good. Keep the belly up tight. Release that hand. Other side. So right fingertips to the left, extending the left arm now. Now open up those feet even wider. Good. And if you can, get a nice grip on the outside of those feet, your heels, maybe even your shins or your big toes. Keeping the legs straight, begin to bring the body weight forward into those toes. Keeping the grip, pulling those shoulders down, use the bicep strength, bring that forehead to the floor. Good. Hold here. Release the grip, bring those hands back in, slowly push yourself back up, lock those feet in just a little bit. Good, bring the hands to the hips and slowly rise. Turn the right foot out. We're prepared for triangle. Now a triangle, both legs stay straight. Arms extend, just like we did in Warrior Two. Reach the right arm forward, and then bring the right hand as low as you can while keeping that right leg straight. Drive that left arm up. Holding here. Turn back to center. Bring that left arm forward. Bring the left hip with it. Drop both hands to the outside, either side of your right foot. Square off that back foot and bring that forehead to the right knee. Try to keep those legs as straight as you can. Constricting that throat to bring your chin to your chest. Good. Now bring your hands to your hips. Slowly rise. Good. Let's do the other side. So just bring those toes forward so everything's squared off. Open up that left foot. Both legs stay straight. Arms extend. Hold. Reach the left arm forward. Drop it down. Hold this triangle pose. Remember, both legs stay straight, so you come down only as far as you can to make that happen. Good. Bring it back through center. Right hand now to that bottom or to that leg, reaching that left arm up. Reach, reach, reach. Walk those fingertips down. Good. Bring it back to center for a moment. Bring that right arm forward to meet the left. Bring the hip with it. Good. Slowly release. And bring that forehead to the knee. So you can bend that front knee as much as you need to get that forehead to knee connection. Bring that right hip forward with you. Keep the belly in. Good. And then hands to your hips. Use that core to slowly rise. Good. Chin comes up last. Square off those feet. Bring those feet together. And one more time, we're going to flow. So bring those feet together. Hands in prayer. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, release. Step those feet back one last time to your plank position. Move through your vinyasa into your upward dog. Move through plank, downward dog. Good. Walk those feet forward. Have a seat. And come down onto your back. Good. Let's move into a shoulder stand. So bring those legs up. Good. Give it a little push on the mat. Drive those legs up. Bring those hands right to the hips. So I want your feet right over those hips. Belly is in. Your chin is toward your chest. Shoulders pulled down. Good. Make sure those feet are right over those hips.
arms flat on the floor. Drop those knees down. Frame your head. Good. And then nice and slow, drop it down until those legs come all the way down to the floor. Good. And then pull that right knee in. Use that left hand to gently guide that right knee over your left leg. Keeping both shoulders down. You can look over that opposite shoulder. Good. And release. Let's do the other side. Pull the left knee in. Guide that knee over with your right hand. Keeping both shoulders down, looking over that left shoulder. And release. Both legs extended. Pull both knees in. Round yourself up and come right to a seated position. All right, guys, let's bring our chin to our chest. Let's bring our hands to our knees. Bring those hands to prayer. Say a little silent message of gratitude for finding yourself on your mat for these past 90 minutes. A little note of gratitude for this self-care, for the positive version of you that